respected members of ICAP, members of the election committee, Assalamu Alaikum. First of all, I would like to thank you all for sparing your valuable time and coming to this professional get-together. I'm also thankful to the election committee for giving us this opportunity to share our views with the honorable members. My brief introduction, my name is Saifullah, and I am fellow member of the Institute of Chartered Accountants of Pakistan. I qualified in 2003. I did my articles from Rafaqat Babar & Company and currently working as a partner audit and insurance in the same firm. My services to the Institute, I served as a member of the Northern Legion Committee for two consecutive terms, 2009 to 2017, and as the Honorary Secretary of the NRC for 2 years, 2011 to 2013, as the Chairman of NRC for the year 2014 and 2015. I remained an active part of the CPD Committee Peshawar for the last 12 years. During this period, we have taken various initiatives for enhancing the quality and volume of the CPD activities. In order to provide same level of CPD being offered in large cities, we have live telecasted various seminars in Peshawar through video conferencing, and later on extended this facility to Multan and Faisalabad as well. In order to take full advantage of the technology, during my term as a chairman, for the first time in ICAP history, NRC started e-learning in January 2015. Which has now become a preferred medium for CPD activities. This was an objective well achieved, as the overseas members are members who are at their remote work location, and those who do not find sufficient time to physically attend the required CPD sessions can now carry on their required learning in diverse field of interest. On social side, we annually organized family get-together in Peshawar and all other cities of North. The basic objective of this event were to give an energizing break to the members from the routine pattern of work pressures so that they can enjoy some quality time with their families and friends. The students of the ICAP are our real asset, and recognition of this fact, we have upgraded the libraries by improving the existing facilities as well as providing additional books and computers throughout the North region. In order to develop their soft skills, we also organize cricket tournaments and other sport activities for our youngsters. We have also arranged refresher courses for CA students before their exams. We have also organized the first ever CA student conference in 2016 in Lahore. In order to facilitate and ensure participation from small cities, complimentary transportation and accommodation were provided to the students of these cities. After spending almost 8 years as a member of NRC, it may reasonably be claimed that collectively NRC has functioned as the most robust and vibrant arm of the ICAP. Together, we have succeeded in bringing the same to the limelight and to a stage where members very keenly participate in its CPD and social networking events. Now I would like to highlight some of the key areas which I shall focus if elected as part of the ICAP Council. We should strengthen Institute Secretariat by equipping it with quality human resource and evolve ICAP Council into a true policy-making body. In this way, council member will spend quality time on strategic and policy matters, while operational matters will be trickled down to more proactive administration. I suggest as a first step, a full-time CEO should be appointed for the ICAP. As I said, our students are our real asset, and the success of our institute lies in inspiring and attracting talent into the profession. So we should take every step to make ICAP qualification a first choice for the students. To attract best talent into the profession, ICAP qualification should be marketed in a manner that student fear about difficulty in passing CA exam should be eliminated. We should take ICAP qualification to remote areas and provide greater financial support to the bright students. We should also market CA Pakistan in Afghanistan, Middle East, and Central Asian states. Some years back, ICAP has fully exempted CAF to graduates of some leading business school of Pakistan. I believe it as a job half done. The other half of the job is to negotiate reciprocity with the specified degree institute for the CAF qualified students. Some issues like articles in industry and exemption given to some different universities need to be revisited, and members' concern in this regard should be addressed. Currently, there is no nomination from North Zone B in various ICAP committees. I shall make efforts to nominate honorable members from this region in various ICAP committees so that we can also contribute our share towards ICAP professional and other relevant activities. ICAP should also strengthen its relationship with the regulator like State Bank, SECP, FBR, so that ICAP can participate in government economic policy making. I believe this will act as a catalyst for creating more opportunities for our member in public and private sector. ICAP should allocate more funds to the regional committees and equip them with the state-of-the-art IT and communication infrastructure so that they can impart knowledge and skill relevant to each member. SMP, which is the engine of growth of the profession, should be duly regarded and supported. Industry to practice transition should be made more easy and smooth so that entrepreneurship culture is promoted for ICAP members. I'm of the view that we should bring overseas fraternity in the loop to address their feeling of disconnect. Like regional committees, ICAP should provide necessary funding to the overseas chapters for CPD and social networking events. In the proposed changes to the CA ordinance, there will be reserved seat for overseas member in the council, but that will be through nomination by the council. I believe that this should be through direct election, as the right to elect representative should be with the overseas member, not with the council. Lastly, ICAP should hold regular meet the representative session in each region to seek feedback and suggestion from the members on all critical matters. After putting in 8 years at the NRC, I feel more committed and resolved, and assure you to continue my endeavors with the blessing of Allah Almighty and to effectively represent the worthy members in the ICAP Council. Thank you. Thank you very much.